That's the coolest looking armor, so maybe that's the magic armor.
This is my new character.
It's still Hayden, it's just new armor.
It's new armor.
The Devon.
Can I get some health back?
Oh, I can't.
Why do I have this still?
Well, that's all carved on your back.
You gotta keep that.
Literally a knife. Someone like carved it, like a cut you to make that symbol. And it really hurts. It's still like trying to scab up and it bleeds. And now you put on your armor and it feels so painful because the armor's like hitting it and it's like hard to even move. It hurts so bad.
I mean healing.
Can't do that.
Give me one.
Got him, and then immediately went back to rest. But we didn't go through the resting portion.
Wait, what? We got who?
This is where Hayden was.
Yeah.
And then you went back.
I'm sorry, I was on that side. It's different.
Yeah, and then you went back.
Can we go do like a sleep, like an easy sleep, like a?
You can try to rest. I mean, you can either rest in the dungeon, or you can leave the dungeon, but I think you chose to go over there. So, are you guys gonna try to stay the night there?
Yeah.
And rest up?
Yeah.
How are you guys
on? Yeah, but we need someone to watch.
How are you on spells?
I only have three spells.
I only have two. Left.
And I know Morris casted some spells too, so he's... He's out of first level spells. He's only got one second level spell and one third level spell left. Okay, so you're gonna try to rest. Mm-hmm. So that's three watches. So.
I'll watch first.
Okay. Who needs a lot of healing?
Me. Oh, I don't.
You're good.
Wait,
you can take two watches if you want. You don't need sleep.
Wait, hold on. But could I give, am I able to give, one of my health to him?
No, how are you going to do that? Like, you give him the kiss of life? No, you're not magical.
But I need some healing up for.
He has magic stored, magic healing stored in Life Judge. So if you ever want to, cast one of your spells, you can basically knight them. You can touch them with your sword and let one of those spells go through to them if you wanted. That's an option too. In a bind. You want to do that now?
There's so much good stuff in the party fund that I have planned to use against the Necromancer.
Okay. We'll see.
I have good stuff.
Wait, okay. I have that ring of. The Ring of Protection plus...
We're at level 4.
Yeah, so the Ring of Protection, what that does is it adds to your AC and it adds to your saving throws. So anytime you get hit or you make a saving throw, it gives you a bonus.
So the King and Queen gave me that?
The King and Queen?
We don't know where you came from. You can make it up. Maybe you got it from one of your elven relatives. Maybe it's an elven maid. Where did you come from? What woods did you come from?
I think she came from... I don't even know.
I think she came from...
So you guys are all the way up here. Most of the elves are down here, but elves can live in any of the woods. This is down south. This is up north. This is where you guys are at now. This is like swampy area.
Carve this tattoo off,
are you from?
This mark thing, and put a tattoo.
You're from down there?
On my back.
That's interesting because you chose the elven capital of Runalen. So you're a capital girl. You're a city girl. A city girl.
That seems like her. Like
definitely.
So you're from Runalen. That's interesting because a lot of the elves in my other campaign were from Runalen. So
Brian.
So you would have maybe had some. A contact back in Runalen that gave you that.
Necromancer lives right in there.
Anyway, so what are we doing? Are we resting? First rest?
Yeah.
On a one or a two, something happens.
The first second.
Brian.
On a one or a two.
One or a two, something happens. What is it?
3.
Give me a... Don't lie to me, boy.
I have 4.
Second watch?
2!
Okay, give me again.
Wait, I'm doing the third one?
Okay, Brian, second watch.
Brian, he was gonna hit me with a sword.
Go for it.
4?
Yeah.
I call it the 2.
Plus, is it a plus 1 or is it just a straight D4?
Just straight.
Okay.
I call it the D triangle.
Just get rid of that one.
We should start
stored.
Calling it the D triangle and then.
D triangle.
Yeah, instead of the D4.
Alright. Mason's. I'll be second watch.
I'm at low health. I did second watch. Something came on the second watch. Did you not hear him?
You hear something scratching at the doorknob. What do you do?
At the doorknob behind me?
Well, your guys are in the wood, in there. Everyone's scattering around. Oh, by the way, that other guy that was in there that you heard, he bled to death while you guys were doing all this. Okay. So you have a dead guy in there with you laying down.
Oh.
I know what to do. Am I able to pick up that guy and then and then open the door, throw it on whatever's there, and then just start attacking it?
Is that what you want to do?
Yeah, I'm really good.
You're just gonna open up the door.
Yeah, I'm just gonna put it in front of me so they can't see me. Just chuck it at it, whatever it is, and then.
Okay.
Wake up, this is the good idea.
So, are you gonna wake anybody up first, or are you just gonna do this in silence?
We gotta burn him after.
We gotta wake him. Wake us up.
You guys gotta lay your characters down where they're sleeping.
Yeah.
Wherever they're sleeping.
Who's this?
Put them exactly where
that's
you guys are
Russell.
Sleeping.
That's Russell.
That's Russell. Alright, lay your characters down.
That's actually a fire character.
Lay your characters where you're sleeping.
Fire.
Grady, can you help lay those characters
down?
Grady,
lay them down wherever you guys are sleeping. Because we gotta know if he's opening up the door.
Don't make him too far.
He can sleep in his dang bed unless you guys kick him off his own bed, which probably makes sense.
We're not letting this kid sleep on a bed.
Yeah, you're taking his bed.
He's like, get off! He's like, get him up! I need some rest, I'm alone.
Yeah. Hayden's like, you guys tortured me, I'm taking your dang bed, kid. So, you hear this at the door. Describe to me what you're doing.
So I'm telling them they're woken up.
You did? You go around and wake them up? Yeah. I mean, because...
So do I...
Hold on, slow down.
My spell?
Slow down. So, you're going to try to wake them up before you do anything.
I mean, yeah.
Okay.
Wait, hold on.
Slow down. Slow down.
Don't lift them up.
Slow down!
Nice.
So...
You don't need to raise your voice. Brian's already telling them to slow down. Don't need you to.
You're able to wake up this many. Pick who you woke up.
I'm waking up my brother. I'm at low health.
You're trying to get some good night's sleep.
Yeah.
Alright, who's the closest one? Alright, Grady. He's close.
The dwarf wants to fight
some. Everyone else is asleep.
Yeah,
no,
I'm gonna tuck it on him. I'm like,
That door starts to.
Kevin.
You see the handle twist, and we're rolling for.
This is scary.
Oh.
Initiative. Alright, they got a 6.
And it's just Darren and Kimmick.
Yeah.
Or not Darren and Kimmick.
No, it's Kimmick and Utro.
Yeah.
I rolled a 6 as well. Plus
3.
Two, right? No, plus 1, right?
Yep.
I got plus 1, so I'm 7. Okay.
What did you get?
3.
Do you have any? Oh, yeah. I got a ham. I don't like when someone creaks on the door and scratches it and then opens the door.
We've only been against scary. All right,
ready?
Ready,
guys?
Here we go, Mace. Wait, here we go.
So am I able to do this all at once?
Take your
disc
here, open
the door, chuck it at him.
So the thing starts to go, and tell me what you're going to do. So you can move your amount of movement.
That's not me.
Where was the dead guy?
Right here.
Yeah.
I picked him up.
Yeah.
Okay, but where was he? Because you guys hear him
moving? Right here.
All right, so that's 5, 10, 15. You pick him up, and you get back, and that's 30. So you're you're at the door with this dude holding the dead body. When the door tilts open, creaks open. Ridiculous
growl.
Aura of cold. It's freezing cold around this thing, and it's got blue eyes, and it's staring at you.
It opens up the door.
I'll give you an extra one to your AC because you have a shield.
Basically, I'm literally tall as heck.
It's my AC.
And it snarls at you. Intruders.
Throw the thing at it!
You can't! Can I?
Hmm?
Can I throw the body at him?
It's his turn. And he comes up to you and attacks.
The body's in front of me. Then you'll throw the
body
into me.
That's why you're gonna get a bonus to your AC.
I'm 22, what's the difference?
Oh, that was...
Nothing when he rolls a 2. So... He swipes at you with his nasty hand and misses. And then he backs up like 3 squares.
Why?
1, 2, 3.
Oh, because I told you what I was going to do, so you...
No, because you can immediately tell that whatever this is a lot smarter than a zombie.
Yeah, it's not just like a skeleton. Still
okay. Wait, that's Moe's.
Wait.
Alright. So, next is Kimmick. What's Kimmick doing?
Throw the body. Just ram the body with.
Like, no, throw the body at
him. He's holding the body. What are you doing?
Oh, he's holding the body. I'll use the life judge.
Alright. Run up into his face and hit. If you want to swing, you gotta get up in his face. Move your adventure.
Remember,
he's very cold.
That won't do anything.
We got
8.
Oh, gosh.
Plus what?
My turn.
All right.
Plus what?
I think.
Oh, an 8+5.
8+5. 13. 13.
Does not hit.
What is his AC?
Not allowed to know.
Sometimes he tells us our the AC. What is the AC?
Now it's a trish.
Is that a match? Yeah, it is a magic weapon. Okay, duh. Okay, Petro, back to you.
Alright.
Bow and arrow, let me.
So, I'm gonna use the guy on my shield, hold this. Boom. Right? Can I do this?
What are you doing?
So, I'm holding him on my shield, right? I have my arm around him and then I'm throwing him.
There's no way you can hold a whole human and shoot a bow. There's no chance.
Okay, so
can you throw the body and then shoot? Or
no, because
two actions.
It says two actions. If you drop the body, you can shoot, but you can't like shoot while you're holding the whole body.
Wait, Mason. You should ram him so he's away from me.
Ram him with the body?
Oh yeah,
just in case he gets knocked back.
Yeah, that's a chance if it might hit Granny, right?
If you shoot your bow, there is a chance.
Okay, so I'm straight with the dead body.
So you're gonna just charge
Wait,
in.
No, I know what I'm gonna do.
It's smart, right?
I'm gonna put the sword through the dead body, then use the dead body as a sword and run, and the sword will go through him.
Okay, but it's gonna take an action for you to pierce the dead body, get it all the way down in your sword, and then run. You can ready your sword if that's really what you want to do.
I'll just use the body as my shield and the sword right here.
Drop the body and fucking
attack. Okay, fine, I'll just drop it.
You just really want to do something.
No, ram the thing!
It's cool, I mean, I like it, but...
Are your eyes okay?
Yeah, they're itchy.
Alright, Mace, what are you doing?
What are you trying to do? Is that what...
Hit him with my sword.
Are you just going to drop the body?
Yeah.
Alright. Okay, he drops the body, Beep plops down, the red guy plops down, and then you're charging up?
Yeah.
You don't have to if you don't want to.
I can't get out of here.
Alright, and you're attacking.
Sean!
Roll your dice, Mace.
Okay, next is the enemy.
Oh my god.
Go rinse them with water. Wash your hands with soap.
Okay. What's it? A 4. Holy crap.
Nobody's really good.
He's gonna back up another, what is his speed? 30, so he's gonna go halfway, so 15. Another 3 squares. Push him straight back. There you go.
This thing's smart, actually. You should bow him.
I don't have a bow.
Kimmy, are you going to pursue or are you going to... What are you going to do?
Wait, I feel like he's leading us to a trap.
So, remember, everyone's still asleep. Everyone else is still asleep.
Back up again.
He keeps backing up. He missed and then backed up again.
I'm in? Oh, yeah.
I feel like I should hold because he might be leading us to a trap if he's backing up.
Whatever you want to do.
I'm going to hold.
It's just that I'm just describing the situation. Do whatever you want with it.
Chris, do you have a bow?
Yes.
Bow?
So you're going to hold. Mm-hmm. You guys are just holding the door. Okay, back to a tro. Are you going to hold the door or are you going to shoot him?
I'm
going to
bow.
Okay. Bow. He pulls out his bow and he shoots. Go.
Oh, wait, I feel like that's kind of smart. He said 20!
Wow! Plus 7!
Wait, 40?
So that's so you're a fighter, so you get maximum damage plus your attack bonus, I think, right? That's my rule, right? I have a rule somewhere. Whatever. I think it is. I forget, we don't play now. Okay, so yeah, you do, because you're a pure fighter. You get maximum damage, which is 10, and then you get your bonus of your plus 4.
So it's going to be 14 plus a d8.
Let me check that thing. Hang on a second. Let's see.
Fake.
No,
it feels hot around it.
Fighter.
Rinse it with water. Wash your hands with soap. I'm going to tell you how much you guys touched.
Can you leave Miami lost in the shoes?
Yeah. Pure fighters land a critical hit, they deal maximum damage plus additional damage equal to their base attack bonus. Wow.
So is it 14
points of damage. So you do your maximum. So your maximum is a 1d8 plus 2, so that's 10. Plus your attack bonus, which is 4, so that's 14 points of damage. Holy cow.
I'm him!
Yo.
Thank you. thing is seriously injured now. Okay. He's still alive, though. Is that a magic bow?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah, it's a longbow plus two.
Okay.
All my weapons are
good, because this thing can only be harmed by magical weapons.
So if this was us in the beginning, we wouldn't be able to kill him, right?
Whatever it is, can only be harmed by silver or magical weapons. Next is the enemy.
Isn't that all the weapons?
And he turns and goes 60 feet, double moving, sprinting up this corridor.
Up the corridor? Wow.
To me, 60.
So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50,
I think he's 60. I think he's going to tell the necromancer.
So is he his back towards?
Yeah,
so we can get it. No, we can.
In a really weird, grotesque run,
he's sprinting
away.
He's running away from us. We can get a
double attack.
Extra attack.
You're not in melee. So if you're in melee and then retreat, then you get that bonus. You get to a free attack.
What's the difference?
Because you're right next to him. So if he turns his back, you can just whack him in the back.
He was
already way over there, so you can't just hit him with your sword 15 feet.
I think he's going to get healed by the necromancer.
The fighting withdrawal is only out of melee. So melee is the square next to you.
One of you guys should come over here and go.
We're sleeping.
Everyone else is sound asleep. What are we doing? Are you guys going to pursue this guy? Or are you
going
to...
I think he's going to kill the necromancer.
He has some snores.
He's almost dead. The necromancer, he probably ran into the necromancer to tell them, I want to run up and bow him.
Okay, run up to the edge?
To the edge.
Okay, so what's your speed? Your speed is 30, so you should be able to get there, right? 5, 10, 10 15, 15, 20, 25,
yeah. You want to come forward to 30?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so that should be short range, 70 feet short range, so you're going to do plus 8.
Plus 8?
Yeah, because you're within 70 feet.
Oh, 11.
Plus 8 hits.
Mom, give me some. 11 plus 8 plus 2. 10.
He's dead.
Mom, 11 plus 8 19. He's dead. He's dead. He's dead. How do you know? He's dead. There's no way.
You hit him in his back, and he's running, and he's going around the corner, and...
Oh, I knew he was coming down here to get the necromancer, but he couldn't do it.
Well, we don't know what he was doing.
Now what do you do?
I go back to wake up the others. Wait, it
didn't... No.
The second watch.
Have a third... The second... Whatever.
Third watch. And that's you since you woke up.
Yeah, I'll take the watch.
Yeah.
So everyone gets rested.
But for a third watch, I think he should be watching from this corner. Like, so we can know what's coming.
No, he should be watching from here, because if he's watching from this corner, what if something comes out of there?
What if a guy
so,
goes
so that was the second watch, so now you have one more watch to go to get full night's sleep for these guys.
No, because we want to watch there so we can see if anybody notices zombies.
You can sit against that wall if you want. Whoever wants to take the watch can take it out there. You just took year two, though, so you're probably going to go back to bed.
Yeah.
So whoever's going to do the next
that's
watch,
crazy.
If you want, you can sit out in the hallway. That's fine.
Yeah, I'll just do it.
Are you seeing me passed out there?
I'm passed out, bro. Okay. I ain't
like it. Wait, no, not by the swivel door.
No, just do it, in the corner, maybe right here, so you can see both sides. You'll be fine, won't you?
You got to, Grady, do what he's Kimmick, do what he's comfortable with.
Yeah, what are you going to do?
No,
I am the fox.
Sleeping. Kimmick can make his own decision.
So I feel like something is gonna come through the swivel door. But
stay back.
You creep
stay
down
back
a little bit.
I'll just stay there.
Right there.
There's nothing gonna come out.
Well, you don't know.
Well, you can see all three ways. So that's
they're not
okay. Are you gonna stand up, or are you just kind of sitting down against the wall there, relaxing?
Stand up.
He's on edge. 4 hours. Mm-hmm. Alright, everyone else doing your sleep?
Yeah.
What is it, Mace?
3! Oh. I swear, I'm
okay.
I swear, right?
Don't touch my dice. I'll let you read them.
Just read it. You don't gotta touch it.
All right. So, the next watch passes.
Nothing comes.
How do you know?
It's one or two.
Easy. All right.
You can't do that, bro.
Right? I can't even.
You're aggressive. All right. Now, you guys all wake up in the morning. Get your one hit point back. Anyone who needed your one hit point?
One hit point plus
your constitution bonus if you
can
have.
Can I erase all my spells?
So Brooklyn has. Yes, and you get all your spells back.
My constitution's 13.
Wait.
No, it's your plus.
You should have used
so
all
I have
your...
plus one. Oh. So does it become a plus two?
Yes, you get two back. So you get your one plus your one. So two. You get two health back.
Karma, no, I already have health.
You could have used all your health potions on Russell, and when you got your full night's sleep, you get all
your
potions. But
I get my spells back.
I know. I did. I erased it.
But remember the night before.
Use your
spells.
Russell.
You gotta remember
to
do
10.
That.
I only have 10, so.
You already slept. But remember, next time, like, anytime you go to bed, before you're done, use up your spells to heal everybody up.
I have 15.
You're up to 15 health?
10 health. But I have, like, 15, like, marked out.
Okay. What's your AC now with your armor?
Right now, my armor class is 12, it says.
What?
Are you ever going to stop playing the...
Hamlin just got injured.
What?
Tamar Hamlin just got injured.
You did?
Yeah.
No,
I don't. Some bill cleared up.
But I'll say, is he back on the bills?
Yeah.
Oh.
He played.
You got a plus.
The doctor even said that he wouldn't be able to ever play football again. And he played...
I saw a DC of 17, so it gives you 17.
He pretty much died.
He pretty much died for like a few seconds.
What happened?
His heart stopped beating.
Oh.
Okay.
So he died for like a few seconds.
All right,
seconds.
So your AC is 18. Because you don't have a shield. Okay.
Wait, I do have a shield on my character.
Nah, that doesn't count.
I do have a shield on my character.
But I do.
I do.
What are we doing?
We all wake up.
Go slay the Necromancer.
Thanks, Kevin.
Man, you're bad comfortable, man.
Alright, we're going back to that other room over there, right?
Did Kimmick see the zombie, like, move or, like, any shadows walking or walk footsteps? Great. He's the one who knows. No, okay.
All right,
Grady, you can come
quiet.
Back now.
He woke us all up.
Did you know? I learned this from YouTube.
Hey, Mason,
Animals have to be quiet.
Kimmit,
hey, Kimmit.
If anything happened,
okay, describe me what you're doing, guys.
Like, all right, hey, guys. We're going back to where we came from, right?
Yeah. No, we're going to Necromancer.
Yeah, where we came from over there. Yeah. And then there was that one room where they said that he was at.
The Necromancer.
Okay. So we're moving.
All right. He's not going to be there. There's going to be like 100 traps there.
Well,
we're all going to die.
Can you guys move them?
What order are we in?
Whatever order you think.
All right, me and my brother, Mason and me, since we're brothers, hanging up on front, bro.
So you just want to... You went from, I'm too low on health, to, let's do this.
Well, I think he earned his health back.
I don't know. I still have 15.
Oh, you earned some?
Yeah, I only had 10 health. But I'm still ready. I'm like, that's, oh, yeah, one, yeah. That's okay. An easy one-shotter for the Necromancer. You know that,
all
right,
so we're moving
easy
forward.
Easy one-shotter.
Oh.
What a shock.
We're moving forward.
The easy one-shotter.
Yes. The stick should be... Yeah. For traps.
Brian, I really don't want to tap the floor after how much work I've done.
Yeah, I am. I'm tapping the floors and the walls.
So, like, okay. Can you, like, make sure I don't die or, like, tap out and, like, just run away so I don't...
Moving forward.
Brian, we're tapping the walls. No, no, wait. Pause. We're tapping.
Still tapping the walls.
That's the order you guys are in?
Yeah.
Okay.
Whoa.
eagle still watching over?
Yeah, he's got
it. No, the eagle's outside.
All right, now there you guys got the eagle doesn't carry.
Describe to me what you're doing.
We're still tapping the floors and walls.
Just going in, turning left.
Slowly. The eagle probably left for a minute to get some food.
Remember kickball when we play at reset? It's like, remember it's like, what is bumpy or?
Wait, which room are we going into?
Grady, you and
Mom, which room are
we? Who was your first copy down in history?
Huh? No, we already went in that room. We were going to the room that we thought the Necromancer was in.
If he lied in the beginning of the year, right?
Hey guys, if he lies to us, kill him.
What?
If he lies to us.
Oh, I'm thinking of the beginning of the year, because you were Miss Ramsey's second block in the beginning of the year.
All right, Mace, focus on this.
Stop right there.
My bad.
All
right.
Oh, great.
He's in there.
Everything around you goes pitch black.
I thought it was supposed to be Star Wars music.
You can't see anything.
Wait, I thought it was supposed to be Star Wars music.
Oh, take your sword out.
Morris says, he's casted darkness on us. Roll initiatives.
Wait, no,
he's not.
You're in a complete spell of darkness. You can't see anything. You can't even see your hand if you put it in front of your face.
Oh. It's pitch dark.
He has a spell on us.
Guys, he's not here because it's a Star Wars. It's not the Star Wars music. You said when we're near him, it's Star Wars music. Four. Oh.
I've been playing it the whole time you're in this thing, but this is a different
one.
Hold on, slow down. You first.
Okay. 2 + 2 = 4. So, 2, 4.
Okay. I got 2 + 1 = 3. 2 + 1 = 3.
Not you yet.
Okay, sorry.
3.
4 + 2 = 6.
You have a dex of 2. What's your dex bonus?
Oh, okay.
Is that the top muscle?
Oh, my God.
He has +1.
Why am I not playing? Because we haven't talked yet.
What did you roll?
4 + 1 = 5.
Okay. And then you?
Three.
I think he's in rare form.
Alright. For Darren and Morris.
4.
Hey!
And the enemy.
Can I see?
Does this mean 6?
Yep.
Okay.
What was your roll? Yes.
It was a 5 + 1.
Okay, let's roll off.
Wait, was it? Or was it 4 + 1?
It was 4 + 1. The enemy is fast. You don't even know where he is. It's pitch black. It's magical darkness. You can't even see anything.
Only he can see us.
It dulls out your sword that you are holding. It blanks it out.
But the elves can see in the dark.
Not magical darkness.
So, but they can cast magic on magic users?
But
cast magic on them.
You as a magic user and Morris know that you can counter darkness with light. So someone's gonna just need to cast light. But you have to get around to your initiative to be able to do that.
Well, I didn't know.
In the darkness, Morris feels a terrible touch. He must save versus spells.
on him, he feels a terrible crush.
Because he knows he's the best person.
So Morris needs
what
a...
What is terrible touch?
Someone get a d20 ready to roll for Morris. He needs a 13.
Oh, wow.
Come on, Mom. You need a rock and roll it.
12. That's so close.
You hear Morris squeal, but you still don't know what the heck happened because it's still pitch black.
Wait, somebody touched him?
Something. Something got him on the back. No. Next is Alicia.
I'm gonna use the scroll light.
Scroll of light.
I don't even know if I really want to see what's going on.
Well, the thing is with a scroll, is you have to be able to read the dang thing.
What if I already know it?
That would be a spell. If you have a spell prepared, you can do it. Which you don't need to prepare individual spells. If you know it, you can cast it.
Okay.
So if you know light, you can do it.
Okay, so it doesn't matter if I'm checked it
you
or
don't
not?
Need, no, just check it when you use it so we can keep track of what
okay.
you use.
Okay, that makes it a lot easier.
Yeah, you
okay,
don't,
I'm gonna
you
cast
don't need
the,
to prepare.
Okay.
I changed that rule a long time
okay,
ago.
Okay, I'm going to cast the lights.
Remember to read the magic
spell.
Section of my home rules because I have some like a little bit of changes to the that
okay.
make it a little bit easier, honestly.
Okay.
Because you can actually cast spells even when you run out of spells, but it's a major risk. Like, read your yellow sheet.
I feel like I'm going to right now.
That's the point. Okay. So what did you do? You cast the light?
Yeah.
Okay. So she casts light on the space, and where exactly did you cast it? Right where you're at in the middle?
Yeah, like within the vicinity of like a circle.
So basically, yeah, that essentially would have nullified it.
So then
so now you can see.
Morris fell.
Can everybody see, or is that just me?
No, everyone can see. You wiped out the magic cloud.
Wait,
basically.
Does Morris
okay.
fall? Does like fall? Does Morris fall to the ground?
No, I'll tell you in a second.
Hey, you didn't put Darren up there. Oh, never mind. He's an ally.
Dang, music messed up. Okay. All right. So. You don't see anybody, but you see Morris is like, his skin looks pale. He looks stinking dead, basically, like sick. And he's like, something got me on the back. I don't know what it was.
Look at him, guys, turn him around. Alicia, or no, Brooklyn,
you don't see any, like, specific markings, right?
Okay.
It's just like he got hit by something. Or touched, or
can
something.
Can I heal him?
But it was so dark,
touch.
He wasn't able to see.
Can
okay.
I heal him?
Hmm?
Can I heal him?
Yeah, if you want to heal him. You want to cast a spell on him?
Yeah.
Because you need
one?
Him.
Do I use this
he's like our best magic.
Well, actually, you know what? You need to wait until your turn in initiative. So Alicia went, and then now it's Hayden. I got used to you being Hayden again. So what are you going to do? You don't know where that came from. Something got him from the back. Morris from the back.
I'm going to like look around just in case like anything's like kind of watching us or anything like that. Like somebody's like... something's in here.
You want to move so you can get a maybe see an angle somewhere? Is there any specific place you want to look? Because from where you're at now, you can't see anybody.
I can or I can't?
I can't. You see the people around you, your guys. But you don't see anybody for where you're at. Where are you at? You're right here? You don't see anybody right here. You don't see anyone back there or this way from where you're at. Do you want to look around a corner somewhere? Do you want to go? Or do you want to stay where you're at?
Stay
safety in numbers?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're holding. Brooklyn, it's your turn. Do you want to do your heal?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're going to go... oh, you're right next to him. So you turn around, and you heal him with your wand. Yep. Oh. Okay, now
wrong
roll,
way.
Roll your D... what is it, D4, right?
This one?
No.
Your heal. is a d4 plus 1. So the black one and add 1.
You can use that.
2 plus 1. 3 points back to him. Okay. Next is Kimmick. What are you doing? You're kind of right in the middle of everybody. You don't see anybody down this corridor straight here. You're facing that way.
I'm gonna move a little further towards that pathway.
Okay. How far do you wanna go?
Tell
me what.
Max.
Okay, max. So 5, 10, 15, 20. What's your speed? Upright.
30.
Okay, so 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. So you can get to here and look this way and you don't see anybody. It's just you still see the little candles and stuff from where Hayden was. And then you see like the cross and all that and the evil stuff and that little statue. You don't see anybody. Allies. Morris says, I feel like someone touched me. I felt like a hand. We need to check behind us.
Can Brooklyn tap the walls and see if there's anything on the walls in there? Or
well, it's not her turn yet. She just healed him. So now Darren is gonna turn, and Darren, he's like, Morris, I'll check. And he runs this way and looks back this way.
Nothing.
He turns the corner and like he saw a ghost. He's gotta make a saving throw. He needs a...
Russell, you're so
11.
Lucky that you're
not it.
Darren is paralyzed with fear for this round, but for another round. He's so scared.
He summoned the devil. He did it, I know it.
You don't see what he can see yet.
I know it's
he, whatever he sees is down the corridor. And now a tro. What is a tro doing?
Don't wanna know. Wait. Is there something like a mirror, like something like a reflection that I could see, like put out and see if I can see back there?
Do you have a mirror?
I'm asking if there's something like that that they like have.
I don't. You gotta do all this in 6 to 10 seconds. Remember, these rounds.
Look at the party fun.
There's nothing in there.
Look at the party fun.
What are you gonna do?
I realize this and I... Can I get like a little peek and not get paralyzed? You know what I'm saying? A little peek. Okay, now hold on.
You know what he's saying? A little peek.
Oh my god, wait a minute. I rolled the wrong thing for Morris. What is that? Total?
You said a 6.
12. Killed Morris.
Okay, so Morris would have fallen completely dead, but it's all right because you came and healed him back up to, he'd be at 2 hit points. Morris fell.
Okay, so he actually
she
fell.
She healed him back up to 2 hit points and then he's like, oh my god, he looks dead still. Like, so yeah, he got plopped.
Okay.
Whatever it was, got smacked by something bad. Yeah, I rolled the wrong thing. I was looking at the wrong thing. Okay. So, what are we doing, Atro? I feel like Mason's paralyzed with fear. What are you gonna do? You can't even think. What are you gonna do? Hurry up.
I said, can I get a
This is a
peek?
Fast situation.
Can I get like a little peek around the corner?
Not from right there.
Okay.
5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. You can get right behind Darren.
Can I double jump and still look? Like,
yeah, you're not going to be able to shoot or anything if you do pass your 30.
I just get a little peek so I don't get paralyzed completely. Like a little peek.
A little peek around the corner.
Yeah,
a little peek around
like
the corner.
Like you're playing hide and seek.
Your bonus for constitution is only plus one, which also means that the bonus that you got for all those levels, you're gonna lose. So 41 hit points drops 5 because you would have gotten 5 bonuses, right? Does that make sense? Because each level, you get your bonus, your constitution, but you're losing one of them. So now your permanent, your maximum hit points is now 36.
What? That's
still alive.
No, I'm not.
I know what to do.
Alright, so now you have to write a career check.
Oh, I know what to do too. Look what I'm gonna do. I'm taking out my...
There, I just boxed off those ones. Those do not... You just lost basically a bit of level of constitution. So that's your max. It means you'll never heal back up to 36, like past 36.
Wait, what? I'm staying there? No,
when you gain a level, you can add more. But you can't heal that back to 41. So, he just sucked constitution out of you. Next.
He's I kind of don't to, know what I'm doing as much as before.
He's going to also back up. His speed is 40.
This is my armor.
Because he's not wearing heavy armor. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 35, 40.
He's scared.
So now you can't see him.
I know
he's gone around the corner and you can't see him. He's gone around the corner.
I know what to do.
Next.
I just really know what to do.
Oh, was right.
It's whose turn? Is it mine?
Alicia.
Yeah?
No, it's Hayden.
That's Alicia.
Let's go.
But that was
Alicia. All right,
remind me to move this.
Ah! Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Your turn. Remind me to move the gold thing.
I'm going to move over to closer to them.
Right here.
What just happened?
Right here?
What's going on?
No, means he didn't fall. He just shot. He's paralyzed.
You can be paralyzed standing up. What?
Can?
Yes. He's like frozen almost. He can't move.
Doesn't matter. He can't move. He can't
move. All right, it's
Hayden's turn. All right, Hayden, what are you doing?
Can I walk over there and do my thing?
Can a tro okay or?
Yeah, he just lost a hit of something. Yeah, it just sucked some life out of him. Permanently sucked life out of him.
Ryan, can I walk over there and then take out my shocks 1d4 nearest creature tails?
You can try to get, no one's gonna be able to reach him next round. You have to get all the way over there. But you can go as far as you can. You want double move?
Hold on.
What is your movement? So it's magic metal, so that should be 30. Yeah, 30. Let me fix this.
Two reactions because I'm trying to walk over here and then putting my creature.
30,
I put my creature.
Can I actually put two?
Oh. Okay. You're gonna go for your. Yeah. So you're gonna go. So you can go 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35. 40, 45, 50, 55, 60 to there is as far as you can get.
And then I want to put one over, I want to put my creature.
You're going to cast your where you want to put it?
Put him right next to it.
Right next to it?
Yep.
All right, let's roll it. What?
Go,
okay.
Hayden.
Are we going air, earth, fire, ice, or water?
What is he basically immune to?
You think about that yourself.
I think he's immune to earth.
Start thinking about what your next move is. Can I think about what your move is?
I'm gonna smash.
Think of the feelings that he gives you.
He gives you cold.
Yeah.
Fire, because fire takes down cold.
You're gonna go for fire. Make a decision. Can I hurry
fire.
Up.
Fire.
He's going for fire. Okay, roll a d20. The higher, the better. Big one.
Hey, Russ.
That's the big one.
That's
right?
Almost the big one.
That's almost
9 to 18 is a medium. Okay, so
but
still good.
Medium's still pretty good.
I got it.
Russ,
get back over here. So this is the column. This is what you do. So you have an 18. Your guy has an 18 AC. He has 27 hit points. He has one attack. He does 2d6 damage.
30.
And then 30 feet movement. Out of nowhere spirals up a tornado of fire.
Can I see it?
With the face of a man. A deranged man. Okay, next round it can act.
Atro, don't forget you have cinders.
Yep, I know. I just...
Oh, did you want that one right next to him?
Yeah, right next.
Put it right next.
Wait, so when you...
You don't actually know he's right there, but common sense, you know that you turn the corner.
So you know like the cookie and melon line and all that blah, blah, blah? You know about what...
Brooklyn.
Well, I was gonna do a gold tornado, but now that he did it, I can't.
So just move closer to the...
What?
Pod.
I was gonna do a tornado that has the color of gold, but now that he put that there...
Well, if you can see, you need to be able to see where you're casting.
First.
You can make a tornado if you want.
Just put it right here, Carlin.
But,
right there.
But yours isn't gonna last as long as his does.
So I would wait, I would save, but I would just move.
You want to be able to see your target.
I'm gonna go over there and say, what's going on over here?
Alright, so move Brooklyn over so she can see down the corridor.
What is your speed?
My speed.
On the other side.
No, it's right here. Never mind.
It's your dexterity, right?
No, speed. It should say,
Oh, movement speed.
Yep.
30.
30? Okay. Weighted it by fives or tens?
Fives.
Okay, it's 30. You want to double move because you're right here.
Okay, so you move there to there. Kimmick, what are you doing?
Could I double move?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna do that.
60, so we move him 60. 5, 10, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60. You can do that last one at an angle if you want. It's the same cost.
Like right here.
Yeah. Okay, allies. So Darren gets himself back up. We're gonna get him. And he runs up and stays with you because.
Wait, I thought he paralyzed.
No, it was just for that. He was that just paralyzed with fear for a
while. Oh, okay.
And Morris comes back here and he's just trying to reassemble. He doesn't want you
to fight.
What is
he gonna do? What is this guy doing?
He's just gonna stay behind. He's not getting involved with this.
He's like,
he'll just follow you guys, but he's absolutely doesn't. Yeah, that's the other thing. He's betraying his master. So okay, Atro, what are we doing?
I can't do cinders, right?
Not from there, it's 15 foot range, so three squares.
The other thing is, there's all these potions that I could do, but like, I gotta get close.
Remember you said you were doing the party fun, don't forget about that.
Bonnie was looking at the party fun. You can always move forward, or see what happens with.
I'm gonna stay where.
Stay right here. You're not gonna
I'll go. I'll move up.
5, 10, 15, 20,
25. I kind of just want to get there.
Okay.
B.
All right.
It's an enemy's turn.
Enemy.
Did the fire do any damage to it?
He hasn't attacked yet. Man, that elemental fire has surprised him. He didn't see that coming. What would he do?
It's like
basically all.
He's got 10 seconds.
10 seconds?
Yeah, he,
Hold.
You guys don't know because you can't see him. So I'm going to turn this away because you don't know exactly what he's doing. But you know he's around the corner somewhere.
Okay.
Alicia?
I'm going to move closer.
Okay. How close?
To behind them.
5, 10.
She can get up there. Okay. Hayden?
Can I move my fire guy?
Yeah.
Can he attack?
Do we know where he is?
But you need to be able to see where to... You need to be able to command, like...
Turn around!
Okay. You need to be able to command where him to go, so you
just
need to get up there so you can see.
With... Attack
the necromancer.
You need to be able to get up there and get closer. You can tell him to go down that hall, but you need to be able to see your guy.
Like my fire guy?
Yeah, like you gotta keep the magic connection. You have to like be able to see him and command him.
So just move forward a little bit.
5, 10, 15.
I'll move right here.
25, 30, okay? Okay, so now you can tell him to go down the hall?
Yeah, don't say, I'm gonna say there's a pit, so don't go too far.
Really? No, he can go over the pit, right?
The thing is, this...
It's higher.
Yeah, it's not...
Wait. It's like a...
He's not putting a lot of pressure on the ground. He's more like...
He's gonna hover across.
Yeah, he's like magically hovering.
So do we know where his necromancer is?
So at this point, you don't see him where he is.
But I say go attack the next.
You can tell him to proceed down the corridor, though.
Yeah. Proceed down the corridor.
Okay. Move him like 10 until you lose sight of him and then stop him. Yeah, that's good. That's about as far as you can see. He's not going to go out of your line of sight. So.
But what if the Necromancer pops up right at me?
Hmm?
What if the Necromancer pops up right
at me? So he's not there. He's not there.
Well, he might be, but you guys can't see around the corner yet.
So you can't see.
You don't even know where the Necromancer is. Because he had a round that you guys didn't see him. So whenever he comes around the corner, you'll be able to see where he is. It's not tricky shit. It's just you guys can't actually see.
Yeah.
So, and your guy, you can't see through the eyes of your guy.
Yeah,
he doesn't speak to you. He doesn't speak to you, so he's not going to tell you where he is.
Got it.
So, Brooklyn, what are you doing?
I need something to come up with.
You can move through your own people. That's fine. As long as they're not in combat, like, as long as they're not in melee, you can move through your own people's squares.
So,
do you want to keep moving or stay there?
Stay where I am.
Okay, you guys are moving very slow here. Kimmy?
We have to follow him anyway.
I'm gonna try to go next to Hayes. See, I'm trying to double move if I have to.
Okay. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60. You didn't actually have to go to the left, so you can be right next to him.
I have a question.
Not like it.
No,
next to him. Yeah.
I have a question. If I use the potion of giant strength, right? Could I get like extra would it be easier to hit him with a sword, like magic sword?
If what?
If I drank the potion of giant strength, would it do better to my sword than
absolutely.
Attack?
Read what it is.
I did. I'm just asking.
So it gives you +4 strength. So your strength bonus goes into your attack and damage. So your attack would go. Where is that? Where's your potion of giant strength? Did we write down one of those?
Yeah, it's in my...
Potion of giant strength. Look it up. It's like page 130-something. Look it up in the book. of giant strength. It's like 130 something. Okay. So, Darren knows that Morris is very injured, and he sees that you guys have kind of taken the point. He's gonna fall back and stay with Morris to keep him safe.
Who?
Darren.
Darren is gonna keep an eye on him because he knows the old guy is really injured, and they're keeping an eye on the back just to make sure nothing else comes out. Move him into that square.
No, I'm looking for giant strength.
Yeah, so now they can see both ways.
It's 130, you said?
130 something. Where all the magic stuff is.
Magic generation.
Magic, like potions. So keep going. Magic potions. Okay. Or is it a scroll? Is it a potion or a scroll? I think it's potion, right?
Potion, yeah.
So giant strength. The tro, you're deciding if you're gonna drink that. Know what it does, but you might want to assess the situation before you drink that.
Yeah. I know. It's saying control giant.
No.
I would move forward and try.
Giant strength.
So we have all of our heavy hitters up.
Giant strength right here. Plus five. Gains a plus five attack and damage roll with melee or thrown weapons and can throw large stones just as a stone giant can. Not that that matters, but yeah.
Yeah, there's plus, no large swords.
With your sword, plus five to attack and plus five damage.
Okay.
We got about a half hour, guys.
I'm gonna make it quick.
You're gonna hold. So you know what this potion does. So whenever you're ready.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you're gonna advance, okay?
Yeah. We might as well all move forward.
Are you gonna get up to be able to see? So, or why is nobody going around the
look,
corner?
Look. I am. But can I use cinders? I can use cinders if I never move.
Yeah. He can still go.
Okay. Then I'm gonna get like
okay.
So.
Fine.
He's like, why is no one going around?
I'm gonna be right here and I'm gonna say, scissors.
So that's where he is.
What? I need to get across the thing.
He had a whole turn. Or had a whole turn and he don't move. And that thing couldn't attack because that was its first.
Can I like hover over me? Alright, I'm telling scissors. Cinders.
Cinders.
Cinders. Can I get him?
It's 15 feet.
Oh.
Three squares. You have to be fairly close. Cinders is good to use when you're in there fighting and you need a little bit more. You're like, wing bang, or like as you're running in, he shoots and then you keep running the rest of the way. Or like you back up and then shoot.
Can he shoot him with the bow from there?
Yeah, you can shoot him with a bow.
Yeah, don't forget you have a
wait
option.
A minute.
What?
You can't see.
What?
I guess the fire.
The fire?
So you'll operate as like maybe a double torch. So a torch does.
Wait, it's dark in there?
Yeah, it's dark everywhere.
Then how did I walk all the?
Because she's got the sword. So over there you'd be able to see, but you've got her on the corner.
Yes. Yeah,
but you do have light. There is light coming off of
him. I can see him.
I would say, yeah, you'd be able to see. This thing is pretty bright. He's a freaking
man-sized hallway.
Yeah, he's a man-sized fire. So yeah, you could barely see him. Like he's
like you wouldn't be able to see right past the necromancer.
Yeah, you can see that his eyes and the horns glowing.
18.
With your bow.
Yep.
Okay.
Plus one, plus seven, plus seven. That hits. On that.
25.
Does it?
What? Don't.
He's powerful.
He is wearing a death shroud. First melee, or I'm not going to tell you everything it does. That one misses.
It's 18 plus seven.
Doesn't matter.
Magic. Wow.
Magic. You can see this magic cloak that he's got. As that arrow got close to him, his cloak came around and absorbed the arrow in magic.
Makes no sense.
Or going against it's a magic very item. Powerful magic person. Alright, it's the enemy's turn.
So I'll tell you the one part of what it does. The first time you shoot at it, it absorbs the thing. So you could shoot again and be all right. The first melee, the first missile attack you make against it, the shroud absorbs. It does other stuff, but I'll tell you that.
I don't know how I'm doing.
This is the kind of stuff, as you adventure, you get cool stuff like that. I mean, you already have cool stuff like this. He's just got his own cool stuff.
Yeah.
When you kill him, you take it.
Yeah.
So next is, him.
He's gonna run.
He is going to use his fourth level spell. Create a wall of bones. Wow. Right here.
He creates a wall of bones?
Yep. So he covers the red thing. You see bones interlocking. And he covers the passageway just on the other side of the thing.
That's easy because I can go and burn the thing down.
Put the pickaxe in front of
me. I'm gonna move forward to them.
And you obviously can't see him again.
No, don't waste the thing. I'm gonna use my potion of giant strength, chuck all the bones at him.
I just chuck through it?
Yeah!
Alright, it's risky because think about where he placed it.
Right in front of the hole.
Yeah, but can I just...
You can always try. You're going to go so fast that you're just going to try to use your giant strength to pile drive through it so fast that it just doesn't even stop you.
I don't know.
I like it. That's awesome. Okay, so...
You also lost constitution, so you might not be...
So let's work our way through the rest.
I'm just moving forward to them.
Yeah. How big is the risk? How big is that?
So get up so you can see at least.
Wow.
And then we're going... Hayden, where are you gonna go, Hayden?
Oh, I'm trying to.
I would get closer.
I would.
And you can also get your guy up there too. You can have your guy attack.
Can he move it forward?
Yeah.
Up to there?
Yeah, you get it. You can wherever you want it. As long as you can see that it's within, I think, 30 feet or whatever, you can read the distance. It's on that sheet, how far away you can go.
I would have him.
Okay, next is Brooklyn. Are you gonna try any type of. You gotta get your butt up there.
Yeah. Russell, can you move her forward?
Yeah, I'm just looking.
Yeah, come on.
Oh yeah, I think he's starting.
Are you gonna do a spell?
Can I do my tornado to block these?
Okay, you're gonna try to make a tornado to break up the bones?
Yeah, because you don't wanna waste like all your...
Yeah, I would use that for him.
Nice, okay.
What was a good idea, Mace?
Well, it might. If this doesn't work, you might consider that.
I'm using my normal spell.
You're not.
Yeah,
spell.
But don't waste your spell.
So it's an end test.
She's got a bunch of them.
Still, you don't want to waste your spell.
Yeah, but this is difficult. It's difficult. Idea. You don't want to risk because if you don't get through this, he's gonna escape, and you have no idea where he could go.
So if she fails, at least there's still a few of you left to try and get through it before it's his turn again.
I would keep trying.
Yeah, I would
So, because if you lose sight, I mean, if you don't get through this in one round, he's going to get out and you're going to have no idea where he is.
And then...
Like, you have to keep him within your touch or else you're going to lose him.
Come on, guys, break
You don't want to lose the Necromancer in the whole valley. Because he's free.
Bye.
Oh, you don't even know what you're rolling yet.
Okay.
So, you're going to roll an int. It's going to be difficult. Plus your int. Which is two. So, you need a... 1, 2, or 3 on a d6. So you're yellow one, and you need a 1, 2, or 3. You don't have to shake it up if you're putting it through there.
6.
Ah!
Ooh. Okay, so your wind started to come up, and it just died out. Okay, mark off one of your novel spells. Or one of your spells. That's all right. If it worked, it would have been good.
That could happen to anyone.
Yeah, you gotta try to get through this. What are you doing, Kimmy?
Come on, just move up with him. You gotta keep going. Quick.
But I can't.
Just come with us. Just follow us.
up to where the pit trap start, like, is about to...
Right here?
Yeah. But wait, no. Behind the fire. Okay, so Mason can run straight through.
Yeah.
Okay.
Allies, they're about there.
Yeah, they're all gonna follow.
Get your butt up here, dudes.
Wait, so he's gotta...
Okay.
And
Tro, what are you gonna do? You gonna do your plan?
I will, but how high is the risk of me going down the ridge?
What?
How high of the risk is me falling in there?
Well, if you fall again, remember, if you don't work, if you hit that wall and you're +5 strength, that's a lot of strength. You're gonna have a good chance, I'll tell you. Your chance is gonna be. You need a 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5 on a d6. So if you roll a 6, it doesn't work. Everything else is going to work.
Oh!
So as long as you don't roll a 6, it's going to work. But if it fails, you're going to bang into it.
And bounce back.
And you're going to bang into it, bounce back, and fall all the way down and get the damage and all that.
I swear, if you go, wait, all the damage out of it?
Well, remember, you're going to fall 30 feet again onto the spikes.
Yeah, but don't you think with him going so fast, he might slip and then bounce back?
Yeah,
not 10 feet. 10 feet is literally as long as this room. You're not going to hit that wall and then bounce all the way back to here.
If you mess me up.
That's why he put it right there.
Please.
Okay.
Wow.
He drinks the potion of giant strength. Dude, that's so clutch because that wall of bones is so ridiculous.
What happened?
Destroyed the bones.
You rolled a 5.
He drinks Tro drinks the potion of giant strength, gets +5 to his strength, and goes and sprints as fast as he can through and busts through. Boom! And destroys the wall of bones.
I can go like
one. Gets right there.
I can go one more space. Right?
It's slow.
No, I can bow him now.
That was your action.
No,
you could use cinders if he is within range.
No, he is.
He hasn't gone.
No, he hasn't gone yet.
He was like right
there. He didn't get his spell.
So he was still right there.
I remember where he was.
He did his spell. Right, and then he would have. He still has his movement. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40.
He did the spell.
That's an action. You still get a. You get an action and a movement. So he casted the spell and then he moved. No, your action was to blow through them. Dude, that was freaking good. Now everyone can see the guy. And he's. Well, I guess he can go again.
What? Oh.
Because it's his turn.
Dang it.
Okay.
Watch out. What happened?
Problem is, he gets to here and he has to pull the lever. So, he's running and he pulls the chain to open up the secret door, right? So he's. That stops him. So he's like, he pulls the chain and he's readying a spell while it's sliding open. He's trying to get out.
Alicia.
Oh man.
Web it, web down, web down. Web.
In enough range.
Oh. Can you like give us a miracle at the end of your pool?
The only problem is I can't do two spells in one turn, right?
Regular. Huh?
I can't do two spells at one time.
I know what to do.
Can I levitate and move?
Yeah, you could. You have levitate spell.
Yeah.
Okay. So yeah, you're gonna cast levitate. So levitate. Basically, you're just hovering.
Levitate and move though.
Yeah, you can move. So basically, you can still keep moving if you want to. You casted it like a, you know how people take a, what's those boards at the beach?
I have my boots.
Oh,
yeah, you don't need to cast the
spell. So I don't need to cast the spell.
You just jump.
Can I run, jump, and then cast a web spell on him?
Fine, yeah. How far do you want to go? I mean, you can cast that a long way. What's the range on web?
Come on,
Warren,
please.
No. I can't, my boots.
You need to have your boots, guys.
And 30 feet across.
If your web spell has a long distance, so
10 feet per level.
So I guess it's not that far. So 10 feet per level, your level is what, 5? 4? What level are you? It's on your character sheet.
4.
So
40 feet.
So yeah, you did have to go fast. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. So you need to get right here.
Okay.
So what was your speed? Yeah, you can easily get there.
Yeah!
That's my web self.
Okay. So he makes a saving throw to get entangled,
No. Or at least at the lever with my web. Right, it's a wide range. So I can technically, if I...
Stop the lever?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, yeah, you don't need to make a save for the lever, but you're going to make a save for him. Or he'll make a save to try to...
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah,
you'll get the lever. That whole area.
Yeah, so the lever is like half... Like, it's not a lever, it's a pull chain.
Yeah, the pull chain, yeah.
So... Really, what you're doing is you're
stopping him
The mechanism from sliding. So it's like already, since it's already time has passed, like halfway open, but it's not fully open.
Okay.
Yet. So.
I have a good bathroom.
Web spell.
Yeah, sorry, next time we'll
wear. Anyone in the area of effect. When the spell is cast, must make a save versus death ray. If the save succeeds, the creature is entangled, but not prevented from moving. Though moving is reduced to one half normal movement rate, such entangled creatures may not cast spells or perform normal attacks. Whether other actions are possible are left up to the GM. Once an entangled creature leaves an area of effective web, it will be able to act normally again. Okay, so basically, you need to choose 8. Wow, 8 10 by 10 by 10 by 10 cubes. So that's a lot.
Necromancer or die.
8 of them? 8 cubes?
8 10 by 10 cubes.
Technically,
one of them is this whole thing is 1.
Yeah.
So that's a lot of web. I mean, you realistically could.
It's like almost from like where the lines are to him, that whole area, right? That whole area.
Yeah, I mean, there's really not a whole lot of. You want to do...
Well, I just want to do generally where he's at.
Yeah, so if you don't want to do it, fill the whole thing, how far do you want? Because you can get this 4 squares that he's in, that's just 1 cube. You want to do that?
Yeah. Can it layer?
I'll give you a bonus since you're not covering a wide area. So I'll give him like a -2 to his save.
Okay.
So, since you're doing a more condensed web, he's a level... So... 12, I'm gonna -2, so he needs a 14. Oops. Ooh, 11.
What?
He gets entangled in the web. Ah. You intruders! You pay for this!
So he can't move!
He can't even move half speed.
Lever's stuck.
He can try to do it next turn, but everything moves slow.
The only thing about the fire is it's gonna...
It'll burn the web!
Will definitely burn the web.
Yeah.
But it will do damage.
But then will he be able to get out?
I'm just gonna use my giant string sword and just whack him.
Mom, will he be able to get out if I use it?
So if the save fails, the creature's entangled and can't move or perform any other physical action. Oh, crap. He can't. He failed the save. So it's half speed if you save.
Oh, okay.
So even if you save, it's half speed.
No.
If the save fails, which it did, the creature is entangled and can't move or perform any other physical action. Speech remains possible, however. Creatures with strength of 13 or higher may be able to break loose. However, each round, such creatures are allowed another save versus death ray with results given above. Blah, blah, blah.
No, so he can't do anything.
He's stuck there.
He's stuck there, right?
You need to just tell me what you're doing.
Yeah, we gotta keep moving.
Is...
Tatum.
Hey.
We're actually not gonna die.
Wait, but if I bring my fire over there, what happens?
You gotta start your turn.
I'm gonna bring my fire guy closer to him.
So
it's gonna burn the web.
I
I'm just putting my fire guy down.
Yeah, just in case. But don't get him near. Like, he can go right there.
Yeah, I'm just putting him right there.
Sure.
And I'm going to move my character.
You can't
so
go
the duration is two turns per right level.
So
you're level 4, so that's 8 turns. That's 80 minutes. So that's an hour and 20 minutes he's stuck there.
So you guys need to move fast and get to him.
An hour and 20 minutes. It's a long time.
That is a long time.
So realistically, you're not even in a rush.
I moved my fire guy a little bit and moved me for like a few steps.
Well, you need to get over that thing.
What?
The hole. Can they run and jump over that or no?
Morris casts his floating disc again to help them out.
So everyone can move forward?
Yeah. So Morris will cast his disc and then
I gotta be
get everyone across.
Just get everybody across. Oh, so he's stuck there for an hour and 2 minutes. That is a whisk.
And the disc is still there.
Can I see the disc?
Are you watching the Deluxe game? Yeah.
So we brought you guys over one at a time over top of the thing.
Huh?
You're
going for the bucks,
really?
I am too. I'm wearing his shirt, right?
What's your marching order here? Get your marching order,
Craig.
Let's go,
and guess what? I have baked Mayfield on. So that yellow guy in the yellow uniform is literally betraying his.
My friend probably all pumped up, has all his
blue shirt on. I'm doing like warrior magic user, warrior magic user. Like something.
Beginning.
encroached on my plans.
You don't have nothing to say.
You talk crap. You're terrible at talking crap.
Alright, let's go.
Russell,
who even are you, you little crap?
Don't tell him.
Just say I'm your worst nightmare.
Shut up, dwarf. Shut up, elf! He's mad. You really in a mad.
Kimmick, you can
He's
talk
like
to
squirming
too.
Around. Everyone can talk to it. He's just stuck
you
in a web.
You brought so much evil into this world.
No.
We just want to live here and people live in peace, and you're creating evil.
How can you live in peace in that dreadful town?
The town isn't dreadful.
It's dreadful. No. The people are dreadful, and they should all pay.
Sure about that, buddy. Sorry.
What they did to me.
They did not.
I've come back to put them in their place.
But it wasn't all of them. There's some bad people.
I was gonna talk. They did nothing to you. All you just wanted to do is be evil and try to kill everybody in the world.
I'm just killing you, okay? No more
deserve it. And most in that town.
No, then you just go after them who deserve it, not innocent people.
You think you can save me, elf?
Or you forgive those.
Forgiveness is for the weak.
Well, it doesn't look like you're in a good position now, are you?
Looks like just
maybe if you turn
we'll see about
path.
Who's in what position.
Listen.
Slice his head and then burn him with cinders.
No, because that will burn the web.
But if you already sliced his head.
Then
no, it doesn't work like that.
Okay.
I'm slicing his head so it doesn't hit.
Well, it's not your turn.
So you're rolling an attack.
Yes, an attack.
Wait. I want to ask him something. He's probably going to say no, though. What else have you done?
He's not going to tell us. Why would he tell us?
Because he just
threatened him.
He's got nothing to lose. He doesn't have no feelings. He doesn't care.
We're going to kill your...
I have so many plans. Things are in motion that cannot be undone.
Guess what? Every single person that we killed.
By the way.
Oh, you're gonna talk back.
Hush.
See, you're gonna talk back to me.
You are part of the plan. You are marked. You can't escape your fate. You can wear your fancy armor, but you can't escape.
Be quiet.
Oh, yes, I can. I escaped from you, Hank, just trying to kill me from
we
you.
We saved
murdering
you.
Me.
We saved you.
No, you didn't. My brother actually saved me. So, you
can't
even hear. I don't want to hear you.
The ink is dry on your story.
Oh, I don't want to hear Mason go slice his head.
We're wasting more time.
You couldn't get out of the web.
What has happened to you? That you wanted revenge from.
Slice.
When I was a boy, I was tormented.
Slice.
I was an outcast. I had no friends, I had no family. I was an orphan, I lived on the streets. I reached out for help and no one was there. I had to find my own way.
Caleb.
Morris says, Thane, that's not true. I tried to help you, and you wouldn't have it. Shut up, old man.
He's not old.
See, so someone did try to help you.
Yeah.
No.
And you don't believe in anybody.
He tried to use me for his own devices. You shouldn't trust this old man.
He uses
all around him with his tricksy magic.
We shouldn't trust you because you're probably making up lies.
Maybe so.
That's why you're
only
so
thing
evil.
I know is I can trust myself and no one else.
You only care about
including
yourself.
That little one.
And he's so pointing to Garrett. Garrett like
just
swallows it. He's like, gulp. Garrett just like slowly backs away.
Alright, I'm slicing. It's
slicing.
Go!
Slice.
So,
20. 9
plus
7. Equals. No, I have the giant strength.
Okay, so.
It's 48.
How long does that last? Did it say how long it lasted?
It lasted for life, is it?
Like, heck, it does. 130 something.
If it did, I would.
He literally cares about himself because he's so evil. Nobody cares about him. All he cares about is his people that work for him and help him. But we slayed them all. I slayed every single one that was out of the town.
Unless otherwise noted, a potion grants benefits for 1d6 plus 6 turns. So roll a d6.
Yeah, roll a d6. Oh.
So 1 plus 6, so 7 turns, so that's 70 minutes. So actually, your spell is going to wear off before the web spell does. Because that's actually 10 minutes has passed, so the same time.
So you still have time.
Yeah, you have time.
Cool. He looks at you.
So you're good, so it's plus 5. So. Frostbite longsword, right? Plus 7, plus 5, so that's plus 12. And he's defenseless, so that gives you him a negative 4 to his AC, which is basically another plus 4. So that's plus. What did we say? Plus 7.
You do it.
12, plus 5, so plus 17. And what did you roll?
I rolled. It
literally
picks up
9. A 9 plus 17 is 26 to hit. Does not hit.
What? No!
Because the other thing that Death Shroud does is it nullifies the first melee. So the first missile and the first melee,
fire.
It nullifies.
Yeah, but so then the next
one.
No, you can't because.
Hit.
No, the thing.
Still won't
fine.
Your potion didn't wear off. It's fine. You can
you
do it again.
Yeah, you still have time.
It's just the first attack against him. Chill out. Who else is gonna swing?
This game is so high.
You can do it again. You can do it again. There's no initiative. So
no, we can't. Okay.
Unless somebody else wants to try and go for it, but if you want to do it,
yes. We'll see what happens. Yours.
It's not hitting. It's a 3.
It's still plus like a billion. So
yeah, but I missed it with
3,
a 9.
3 plus 12. That's because the magic. The first time.
The first round.
The first time you try to hit him with a melee, it misses. It doesn't even. It can be anything.
Okay.
It's magic. Okay. So it magically deflects the first missile and the first whack. And it's done both now. Wow. So now you can just
different.
Hit the guy.
Okay. There's no magic shroud.
There's no magic on his shroud anymore. You wore it out.
Okay.
His AC is 15. So that hits on the dot.
I did.
What does it do?
Be humble, miss.
So plus another plus 5. So it's 1d8 plus 8.
2.
Plus 8 is 10.
He's dead.
Nope.
No, he's not.
Carl, for yours. Carl.
You hit a defenseless man. Cruel.
Carl, do it.
You were willing to kill all of us.
No, I'll do it.
A little bit
so
of the,
you guys don't waste your spells. I'll do it.
A little bit of the
no,
webs broke away at that time.
What do you have? You don't have giant strength.
Is anyone else going to? Dude, he's literally
he's
stuck.
Doesn't
he doesn't wear armor.
He doesn't have anything on him right now. He doesn't even have magic on him right now.
Life judge.
Oh, man, imagine the life judge you're going to get off of that guy if you kill him.
All right.
So the dwarf sets up, and you know what? He has killed two of your brothers. His people have killed two of your brothers.
Say,
what is your speech
you
against him?
Say, you killed my...
Why could you? Why would you?
They were in my way.
Of what?
Plans. I will destroy all of you.
Well, they were just trying to save the world.
You messed them up.
Good.
Since you're so.
A world with less dwarfs and it's a better world.
Oh, we don't want to hear you.
Now I can't drink. Now I have to drink apple juice by myself.
That was a good one.
Yeah. He, as he said that, he spit at you. You obviously have a big old mouthful of apple juice like you always do. You want to spit it even further at him? Just put apple juice in his face. No, okay, so you say that, and what do you do?
the squirrel all around.
With attack him. All right, roll it.
Five judge.
1d8.
What is 5 judge?
It's like a sword.
It's a special magic sword that if a good person kills an evil person, it gives the good person some healing back.
One on a d8.
Well, what did you roll on your attack? Oh, your red.
A one.
On your red.
On your red, on your d20.
Yeah, the red!
Oh, yes, it is. Yeah, it is. What is
three.
It?
Three.
Plus what?
Five.
Eight.
So it's eight. He's got a 15 minus 4 is 11. No, doesn't hit. So you miss.
Mason.
And the web
is
breaking.
I got something to say to him.
He's starting to get it wiggled.
No, we just have to kill him.
He's still stuck.
We can't waste any more time.
He's
starting to break. We have to kill him.
Mason, just keep going. Mason, look. I'm not hitting the web. I'm hitting his face where there's no web.
Then don't miss.
Oh.
If you miss, you hit the web.
If I okay, whatever. 17. That hits.
Yes.
Yeah. You better say that hits.
17.
You want to try something?
She did.
What do you want to do?
My floating sword.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Just don't miss.
Your turn.
Just get him,
you little pointy-eared, skinny runt.
Crappy talking right there.
Hey, listen to me. Your wand. Cast
you
up. Cast up your magic sword.
Nail him.
All right,
calm down. We don't
want to
get too cocky.
So he's stuck, and all of a sudden this magic sword comes into being. Say your magic. How do you do your magic? Get your wand.
I summon.
No, just don't say it.
Say it in the magic tongue. And a sword. Sparkle, what color is it?
Gold.
A if golden we, sparkle we, spin we, around we and become a sword, and it's right in his face. He's like, he goes from mocking you to bitch. And that sword just comes closer and closer. Roll your attack, roll your damage. So, range 100, last 4 rounds, attack plus 3, roll your plus 3. So your red one
plus
and 3.
Plus 3.
I don't
get, but she's rolling your red.
Yep, just plus 3, it misses.
Oh my god!
This sword,
why does he have so much luck?
He does it, and he's got negative 4 to his AC, and you guys are still missing.
Oh my gosh, can she go get
off?
That lasted 3 rounds.
Yeah, you can do it again.
Hey, no, I don't want to get let.
One more miss and that web is broken.
Dude, trust. I have the best rules. Trust.
You already have the best rules. Let her go.
I have the best rules.
Accidentally
pulled. That's not how you should do it.
Hey, one more miss and the web is broken.
Great.
You gonna try one more time, or is anybody else gonna try?
This time the color is going to be.
What are you doing?
Red.
It's still there.
The same color.
It's still there. You just attack with it.
So you have roll your dice.
You just attack with it again. It doesn't go away. It stays there for 4 rounds.
6.
Are you kidding
me? 6 plus.
Carmella!
That's not her fault. It's the luck of the draw.
If I win, it wouldn't hit.
The web breaks loose. Initiatives.
Jeez.
I would have hit him.
It's
8:03.
Do you guys
want to
keep going?
Yeah, he's going
to get 6.
Okay.
For
once in my life, I get 6.
3. I got 5 plus 2 is
4. I got 4.
I got 6.
You're not going to be bummed to miss the Bucks game for a little bit?
No, I'm fine. Okay.
Alright,
we
so
want him dead.
I got
Brooklyn.
5.
I know what to do after. Guess what? I just don't want to, if I miss, right, like, until halftime, I'll be kind of mad.
Did he have to be home at a certain time?
No, she's usually fine with it.
Okay.
I can let her know, though.
Yeah.
I got 3 plus 1, so 4.
I'm good until if we just don't, like, stay good.
Can I?
6.
Ooh, Kimmick's fast for once.
I got a four.
I never get to be in part. Mate, that's
a four?
Yeah, I got a four. Mace, go. What are you?
I got a five.
A six.
I just let your mom know.
Five plus one, six. All right, we got two. We got Mason smashing coming in. Then we got you with life touch.
What
was
it? Boom,
boom.
Actually, he's got more dexterity than Kimmy.
It
breaks loose and it's his turn.
Don't let him run away.
No, he can't because the thing is still there, so he has to like roll it.
Yeah, only the square that he was in is broken, so he still can't go out that way. The web behind him is still, he's still stuck in, but at least he's
it's
loose.
It's just a battle now between us and him.
Don't let him kill. You have to fight.
He gets to go first again?
Yes.
He rolled a six.
I know. Guys, this is good because he does life judge. Mason brings giant, and then I bring the fire in.
Oh. The fact that we did that in like a chink.
You guys are so excited.
Okay.
Is this Star Wars music? It's not.
Okay. He casts a spell on himself.
Or if he fails it, it doesn't work. Or he just automatically surrounds him.
You see this thing, I guess that stays actually.
Oh good,
he's
that's
nice.
He's
got a 10-foot ring of glowing...
But what? Wait.
10-foot ring of glowing kind of like dark, like black flames on the bottom. They're not like emitting heat or anything, it's just like a cloud, like a fog cloud of black clouds.
Hold on, let him go.
10 feet.
Slay his horns off and bring it to our house.
Superior. No, we gotta burn him though. We gotta burn him. Just in case. We have to burn
him. Okay. He's casted something around him and he's got a 10-foot radius glow of like black clouds.
Brian.
Around him.
Brian.
You can still see him, but you can tell that he's got a spell effect around
Brian,
him. And he's like kind of glowing a little bit. You can tell he's done some sort of magic on himself and around himself.
But Brian,
does some sort of protection.
Next is Kimmick.
Oh, life judging, life judging.
But what if the smoke around him is like a?
Are you afraid?
So
you're all gonna die. So it doesn't matter. What are you gonna do?
I told you I should have hit him. Yeah.
So, Mason,
you're done.
Almost dead.
Why not? He's personality like a rope. He's not literally like the people.
What you doing, Kimmy? A tro, Brooklyn, Alicia, start thinking about what you're gonna do.
I'll life judge.
Yeah,
he's not scared of you.
Alright, so he's gonna go.
But cover your nose, I think. Cover your nose. And
yeah, cover your nose.
And cover your nose and slice up. Cause what if there's some like deadly smoke coming in there with your plug nose?
Yeah.
So just in case it's like a.
So you can't go through your mouth either.
COVID.
2020 COVID-19.
Put the mask
20
on.
20 BC go in. COVID-19.
Yeah.
Put the mask on. Go in.
2019. We need like these like smoke masks. So when like smoke, put it on. And
does the Bills win?
Yeah. It was 31:17, 45 seconds.
No. Oh, it's not 10 feet.
So.
Oh, is it? What did he cast? Okay. No, it's just 1 feet around him. It's not ten. It's 1 feet.
So that's good. You just
so it's just kind of just around it.
So you're good. You could just walk up, stab it right through the smoke, come back in, slice.
What did the smoke do? Did anybody know?
Oh.
What did the smoke do? What is?
I know what I'm gonna do.
All right, move in.
Yeah. All right. Mace, can you move me in one front?
Behind him. Go behind him with that extra plus.
Okay. It's so it's just like a foot around him. It's not 10.
What does it do? Do you know?
You don't know what it does. He's warded himself somehow. All right, ready. What are you doing?
He's lying.
So I'm gonna use my left judge and hit him.
Okay. So yeah, you're gonna get up to him.
20. He got 20.
Natural 20.
Yes.
Plus 5.
It's 25.
Okay. Yeah. So that doesn't even. Yeah, that defeats whatever this was because that's not what.
Yes!
So, you're a fighter?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Two.
You don't have to roll because it's maximum damage plus your attack bonus.
Oh.
So, 1d8 plus what was your roll?
Plus 2.
So that's 10 plus your attack bonus.
Plus 3.
3?
Oh.
Plus 13.
2, plus 2,
my bad. Wrong thing. 12.
So
it's 12. Sorry. 12. It went with the music and I was like,
Ryan,
he's Ryan's digging and everything.
He's got a lot of papers for this guy.
Let's find a way so they like.
Because he's got all these spells. He basically has his own book.
Oh.
Well, Ryan's get a workout over there. He does a lot, though.
Wait, I want to...
He's very injured, though.
Can I also move back?
Move back?
Well, you moved up. How far did you move up? Where were you?
Just one page. One space.
You only moved one up.
Right. Oh, you only moved one up?
Yeah.
Here.
Am I, like, right there, too, though?
Back
that
there.
Was the one hitting him, right?
Well, actually, you can only move at your half speed, so that would be... You can move back 10 feet, so to here.
Right.
And Mason was right next to him.
Mason, and he was up. Atro, it's your turn.
Okay.
It's Brooklyn's
turn. Back.
What?
Brooklyn.
Oh,
I'm sorry. Yeah. I already moved it.
Go, Tro.
Have your action ready. You're next.
Because there's no black smoke around.
Right here, and I'm just.
Well, there is. It's just close. It's a 1 foot, not 10.
Yeah, I just want to like do what Kimmick did, like go in there, shine, and like go.
All right, go for it.
Shine.
Remember, you have your plus 5.
Yep.
That's 6.
Plus 5.
So 6 plus 11. 7.
And then wait, 11.
Slow down. 6 plus 7, so that's 13.
15
plus 5.
18.
Is 18. So
almost
his AC
is 15, right?
Is 15. And then he has the magic on him, which brings him to.
No, I thought he defeated it.
Yeah, this magic.
No, this is the spell that he casted.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's got a protection spell on himself, similar to what she does. Plus 2, so it hits.
It hit him.
Come on. One, 2, everybody. Alright, go into it.
Oh my gosh.
Go into it.
voluntary.
Good. That was my elf's blow.
Good. All right.
Don't get upset.
Ready?
Chuck it on the table.
Okay.
3 + 5 + 5 = 8
3 + 5 Well, it's 3 that plus 2
plus
5.
Yeah.
So 3 plus 2 is 5.
10
plus 5 is another 10. 10. Describe it.
Alright.
Describe what it looks like.
Alright. Ready?
You won't.
What kind of weapon do you have?
I've got, basically.
Is it feel it like is it plastic?
Yes.
Oh wait, he's not stuck anymore.
Yeah.
You're gonna need to roll save.
What?
Oh my gosh!
As the life comes out of his eyes, he grabs you with his last breath. His last thing on earth.
No. Wait, what? I find out it's like the magical smoke. I'm dead.
Nathan, did you know that character actually suits you?
Yeah. So I tried it in like a baseball bat, like.
Oh, base.
Sorry.
No! What is it? Is it? Don't tell me.
It's a natural 20.
Oh my god. No.
Okay.
No.
Unconscious and someone can heal me.
No, I'm unconscious. Okay. Can I cast Protection of Evil?
2d6 plus 7.
Protection of Evil!
Before it hits him?
No.
As it's going through his body?
7 plus 7 is 14 points of damage. You're still fine.
14?
Hold on, come here. Let's act this out. Get over here.
Aye.
Go up through here. But now you're really hurt.
You're hurt.
14 damage.
And the last thing.
You took 14 damage.
Okay, it hurt. The last thing, and I just
died. You're gonna do a follow-up. Follow-up stab.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
He falls.
No way. Do it. I'm doing
no way. There's no way.
Oh, we.
Careful.
We did that. No way we did that.
We are him. We are him!
I'm sorry.
gotta go up and then down. Go up over it and down. Go up to where it's skinny and then let it come back down.
Oh, there you go.
Now come back down. There's grooves. There you go. That's fine. Okay.
Since I got the kill, I get the loot. That's how it happens in
you. We're a team.
You guys need to talk. You guys need to start role playing.
I think we should give it to Grady since he's
can't believe we just did this.
Okay, listen. You guys need to start role playing as your characters. Like,
we're looting.
Talk amongst yourselves as your characters.
I'm just like that with my sword.
You are a trope. You talk to Alicia. Hey, Alicia, blah, blah, blah. You guys don't have to just talk to me. You can talk to, you're supposed to be talking to yourselves as your characters. What do your characters say to each other?
Same as Brian's not there.
Yeah, like, I'm not there. So you guys need to be, act like, what would you say to each other?
Guys, I can't believe we just did this.
I know. This is crazy. I can't do anything. Wait, no.
Alright, so.
No, we need to check.
We need to check him. Wait. See what he has on him.
Burn him, take off the hands.
Well, first, we need to take everything
no,
off.
No, we should cut the head so we can show them, okay?
That's what I was saying.
Yeah, cut the head so we're like the famous people in the town and everybody loves us.
Guys,
listen.
But here's the thing.
We forgot.
As soon as we show everybody, we have to burn it.
Yeah, so we gotta burn the head after.
Just in case, like, any other, like, thing can like track its
we forgot to do something.
I think just having his belongings will be proof enough. I think we just need to check him, what we need, and burn his body.
There's
and go.
Also several areas that you
I
haven't
need to
looked
tell
at
you something. We need to look at Necromancer's place.
Okay.
So there's this one, there's this door, there's down that corridor, there's other places that you haven't been as well.
Alright, so let's check him first, and then the next time we
come
that's what we can do, is we can look at the rest of those rooms.
Okay, so...
This mine!
Describe to me what you're doing, so when you get up to him...
Want to see the big one?
You can see the man, he's just a guy, he's probably 30 years old, 35?
Knew it.
He's not that old.
I bet 35.
And, but he looks wrinkled, he looks like he's been scarred, he looks like he's been through a lot. You're looking at him and he's got that bone skull helmet, like, and he's got, you know, he's got the death shroud, which is like his robes. Oh my god.
What?
I completely forgot that he had a ridiculous sickle weapon that he could have been attacking you with.
Wait, what's a sickle weapon?
I was just looking at the spells on the back and forgot about his regular weapon. He's got like a little smaller version of this. This is scythe. He has a small version that is brutal. That's alright. You guys got him off guard and got him scared and he forgot to use it.
I scared him first of fire.
So, you're searching him.
Well, you
guys are searching him.
I don't have any weapons.
So, Death Shroud is like dark, evil robes, skulls, and it's probably not anything you guys
want.
Use.
Yeah, we'll just burn
you keep it, or, you know, it's worth a lot, but also you don't want it to fall into the wrong hands. I'm gonna let you guys make your own decisions.
I think we
I'm describing this stuff.
Okay.
Death Shroud. There is a sickle +3, which is just a magic weapon +3. Bone crown +1.
So, what does the bone crown do? It says +1 on it.
I honestly can't remember. The magic users probably need to study this stuff to figure out truly what this stuff does. He's got this staff as well. He's got a staff with a skull at the end of it and all this. And then he's got a spell book.
Okay.
He's got a spell book. So,
I think Alicia should take that.
Yeah, the sword.
So you're gonna take the Necromancer spell book?
Yeah.
Yeah, and the scythe. I think you deserve the
scythe.
We'll get to take the scythe.
Yeah, well, she can't use a scythe. She can only use the, like, daggers.
Who's
and
the
stuff.
Only one who can
use oh.
Any fighter can use anything. So, but a magic user, your things, your what you can use is listed on your abilities, your class abilities are down there.
All weapons except penalty with all weapons except daggers. So I can only use a dagger on walking stuff.
Dagger, walking stuff.
You can't wear armor or use a shield.
Can Carmella use that?
So I'll take his spell book.
Yep, because now you can learn all the spells that he knew.
Yeah.
And when you guys get a chance, you'll have to go back to wherever you're gonna go, and you're gonna have to spend a lot of time studying it to be able to copy his spells.
Okay.
And Morris is also gonna want to study that thing too.
Okay.
Mommy, can my new name be Bushwood?
And then so we got who's taking the sickle plus three. So that's a plus three weapon, and a sickle does.
I'll take plus
no, plus give, three. No, give it
a to sickle three. Does 1d6 damage. So. It would be 1d6 plus 3 damage and then plus your strength.
Yeah, I'll take it.
You want the sickle?
Yes.
Okay, so right in your equipment, down at the bottom right, equipment.
Oh, I see that.
S-I-C-K-L-E.
We should have looked in this room.
C-K-L-E, and then do plus 3.
We did look in that room.
And no, I'll,
we didn't.
I'll,
no, didn't.
We didn't want to because we thought there was something in there, remember?
So add it over there to your weapons as well if you ever want to use it. So sickle, your weapons down there underneath. You see the new line? Sickle mm-hmm. plus 3. And then how you get your total attack bonus is you take... So write your sickle plus 3. So now for your true attack... Yep, write your 3. What the heck is that, dude?
It's hard. I don't like using.
You don't know how to make it 3?
I don't like using mechanical pencils.
Well, you got it too long. You gotta get closer. Sickle plus 3. Okay, so how you get your total like this bonus mm-hmm. is your attack bonus, so that's 3, plus your strength, plus whatever that is.
Five.
So 3 plus 2 is 5, plus 3 is 8. So you're plus 8 with this thing. And then a sickle is 1d6. And then you take your strength plus this, plus 5. 1d6 plus 5. So yeah, that thing does some beastly stuff. So that's good, because now you don't have to worry about electrocuting everybody. You can use that sickle. Which
I
actually...
can't electrocute anybody, like, when you're in a big group.
I have to do that.
Yo.
Hey, Mel, can
you
know
the thing that... Am I
this? Hold on, we're not done. So next is who's taking the bone crown. You don't know what it does yet.
Wait, was the bone crown the thing
it's this
that...
thing that he's wearing like that.
We just put it in the bag of holding for right
put
now.
Put it in the bag of holding?
Yeah.
Yeah, put it in the bag.
Let's do
it's
it.
Not something we need to wear.
You gotta write this stuff down if you're taking it. If you're not writing it down, you're not taking it. Down here.
What is it?
Bone crown? Bone crown plus okay. one. Bone staff. I think probably Morris is gonna take the bone staff.
Okay.
And he's gonna study it.
What is this?
Morris says we'll work okay. together to identify this stuff and we'll determine what can be done with it later.
Okay. Sounds
I
good.
Guess in the meantime you take it. You put it and then we'll go
bone
over it
staff.
Later. Bone
Stop.
Staff. And then you already wrote down Necromancer
yeah.
spellbook.
Yeah.
You wrote down Necromancer spellbook, right?
Yeah.
Yep, okay.
I might not have spelled too well, but it did.
There's one.
Put the
okay. So you took his stuff.
We have
you
killed
the
necromancer. Slayed his head off.
Now we need to make some use cinders to burn him.
Burn him?
No, I'll use the fire source to burn him.
Yeah.
Oh, the fire source.
Yeah, just
okay.
let me throw him on him. Throw him on him.
Some of this still there.
Fire source.
Hey, yo. What Chill. About the thing that saved him from our weapons when we attacked him? The bow.
That's the shroud.
Can I use
That's
it?
That's the robes. That's what I think you got the shroud, right?
No, she didn't.
Who took the shroud?
No one
did.
Can I take it?
I want it.
That's not like a, that's like a magic user thing. That's the thing that you guys said that probably you should burn or destroy.
Oh, yes, we did, yeah.
I want it.
Because if it gets
Honestly,
into the wrong hands.
A lot of this stuff.
I want the shroud.
No, we're going to burn
you
it.
You want a death shroud?
No, Carmen, we'll burn
I mean, you can, You can, if you don't want to let her to have it, that's fine. But
you don't want
what it is it's like a dark wizard. It's a dark wizard's thing. Like, you put it on, it's a, instead of your colorful pretty robes,
you're gonna be like,
it's black and skulls and bloody and dark and evil.
Well,
is that what you want to be?
No, this, the mini version of that.
He's got it.
Oh.
You have your magic sword with the light. Okay, so Death Shroud, you have, right? You're taking the Death Shroud.
No, we're burning it. We don't want it to get into the wrong hand.
Yeah, we don't want it to
right this
it.
Second you're going to burn it?
Yeah, we don't want
we're
it to
we're burning
get
the body,
hand.
Right?
Are you burning the body right now?
Yes.
How
we
are you lighting
it get,
on
I'm
fire?
I'm throwing him, in, I'm throwing my fire guy into him. And burn him up. Walk into him. Make
okay.
Make the fire guy walk into him.
So, is that what you do?
Mm-hmm.
You use up your guy?
Yeah, use him up for today.
Okay, we will, everyone watches. As the fire engulfs the necromancer.
And then that like
and he burns away. And all the smoke comes up and the webs broke away. And you can see the little bit of light peering through from the thing up here. As his body burns slowly. It stinks so bad. And we'll leave it like that.
And now we're gonna loot the place, okay?
Loot it.
Yeah, there's still rooms to be searched.
We gotta search this room.
Bro, yes. We have this hole over here.
Yeah, and that door over there.
We have to search
that room.
Door over here.
You
don't have to do any of it. I'm just reminding you that there's stuff. But you would assume that there would be some treasure in a big bad necromancer's lair.
Alright,
and we'll do it. He sent me a picture
right when the battery had died. I'm like, dang.
Hey, what do you guys tell Brian?
Thank you, Brian.
Thank
you.
Yep.
Dude, that was crazy. I can't believe we did that.
I honestly can't believe you got him either. The fire. I honestly forgot about the fire. I forgot about the sickle.